on the island of Sodor, on Atha's branch line, there is a small fishing town known as Antonio Bay. Now, Antonio Bay isn't some sort of very important town to Sodor. As a matter of fact, the only real estate it actually gives to the entire island is its fishing community. But it is a reliable town and is served very gracefully by Arthur's branch line. But with any stories, this town has a very, very dark secret. A secret not even the entire island knows about. The origins of Antonio Bay on Sodor takes us all the way back to one cold April night in 1888, not even before Edward was built. It was just after midnight on April 21st, 1888. Six young men were waiting on the shore of what would later become Antonio Bay. Sodor had been facing some hard times due to not having enough money or actually owning an actual railway at this point that ran up there. As you know, the Sodor Mainland Railway and the Tidmouth, Knapford, and Ellsbridge Light Railway were one of the only three railroads that actually ran this area at the time, other than the Mid-Sodor and Scarlet Railway. But no rail lines came up here. On this night, so early in the morning, these six men were waiting for a ship. A ship that had an unusual prophet aboard. Weeks before, the six men had been approached by an older, middle-aged man. The man's name was William Blake. No one actually knows where he was from. Some say he was Scandinavian, some say he was Norwegian, while some say he might have even been Irish or Canadian. No one truly knows where he came from. But one thing was for sure. It was very clear that Blake had a very, very bad disease. Leprosy. And this leprosy-infected man walked up to the six young men one day and asked them a favor. He hid his face in the shadows. This gave him the nickname the Shadow Captain, because he didn't want anyone to see his leprosy-infected face. He had organized a prophecy. Not really a prophecy, but more of a bargain. He asked if he would come to Sodor and to make a colony of him and several other people that had leprosy. They didn't want to cause harm, they just wanted to have a home where they wouldn't be any trouble. The six men, skeptical of the plan, agreed. This took a week to be even thought of, but Blake was sure that he would find a home for his young wife, his mother, and 19 other men and their families. And so, the plan was put into action. Back when he was younger, Blake had bought a clipper ship and modified it for passenger use. He named it the Elizabeth Dane, after his then-girlfriend and before she became his loving wife. The Elizabeth Dane was not a very impressive ship by any standards, even compared to large ships like HMS Victory, but she was unusually large for a clipper ship and very fast. She was Blake's pride and joy, and this would be his ticket to freedom. The plan was simple. The six men would meet Captain Blake on the Elizabeth Dane on April 21st of 1888. On Spivey Point, which is a location in the Sudrian Sea. Blake would show them the gold that he would use to bargain his way onto the island. He would hope that some of the gold would be spared for his own people, so they would actually have something to live off of. Little did he know that Blake was sailing into a death trap. As midnight struck on April 21st, 1888, William Blake and Elizabeth Dane were sailing into the Sudrian Sea off Spivey Point. He was hoping that this would be the final chapter in his long, painstaking voyage to give him, his family, and his friends a better chance at life. Little did he know that he was dead wrong. As the Elizabeth Dane approached Sodor, a thick fog bank rolled in suddenly. It was thick like milk. The crew could not see more than a foot ahead of them. But luckily, the six men had organized a fire to draw the ship in and to anchor as they rowed out in a rowboat toward the clipper ship and her precious cargo of leprosy-infected passengers, waiting for a new chance at life. Legend has it that Blake said to his wife, "Our journey's over, we're almost home." Sadly, they would never reach their home. Once the six men were aboard the Elizabeth Dane, Blake showed them the gold, and in return, the six men gave Blake and his first mate a map of what would be their colony. Blake was happy. He was happy that he would finally have a new home for his people. But that's when things went wrong. Suddenly, the six men draw their weapons and point them at the crew of the Elizabeth Dane, demanding that they would receive all the gold. William Blake was reported as saying it was not part of the deal. The men didn't care. They gave Blake a choice. Give them the gold, or they would all die. Blake conceded, and the six men went on a complete rampage throughout the Elizabeth Dane, stealing the passengers' wealth and their profits, beating those that wouldn't give them their money. There's even one claim that a knife was driven into the eye of Blake's own mother. And once that happened, Blake, his wife, and everyone else were dragged below decks and locked up as the six men went topside. What they would do would be terrible. After closing off any impossible escape route, the men lit gasoline on the decks of the Elizabeth Dane and set her alight. The screams were terrible, wrote one man in his diary after the deed was done. They took the gold and fled in their rowboat. Some of the people aboard Elizabeth Dane were able to escape from below decks and jumped into the flaming waters. At that point, the Elizabeth Dane exploded. She was ripped in two, her mast snapped like a twig, and the ship sank to the bottom of Spivey Point, killing everyone on board, men, women, and children. When the deed was done, the six murderers funded the money to create Antonio Bay on the island of Sodor. But within 3 years, their crimes were discovered, and all six were rightfully hanged as a result. But it seemed to do little good. Once that happened, the tragedy of Elizabeth Dane, the betrayal of William Blake, and the murders were all forgotten. And Antonio Bay was turned into a fishing community. That was until 100 years later. In 1988, 100 years after the fate of the Elizabeth Dane, a thick fog rolled onto the island of Sodor. Its thickest was at Antonio Bay. Over the course of that night, six people were viciously murdered. By the next morning, the bodies were discovered. But no one knew who did the murders. To this day, the Antonio Bay murders have never been solved. But one man knows who did it. Father Malone has been the Reverend of Antonio Bay since 1980. He thinks that the murders were conducted by the spirits of those who were killed aboard the Elizabeth Dane, Blake leading them. But since he indeed was related to one of the members that killed the people of the Elizabeth Dane, Malone often wonders, why wasn't he killed? Why was he allowed to live while six people died? He thinks it's because he showed sympathy to the people aboard the Elizabeth Dane. And every night, he looks out upon the sea of Spivey Point, hoping to see the ghost of the Elizabeth Dane completing her voyage. Now it's said that on every night, the ghosts of the Elizabeth Dane and the six murderers wandered the shores of Antonio Bay, looking for their own ending. The six murderers wanting to escape their deed, and Elizabeth Dane wanting to revenge those that were killed among her. All I have is to say this. The Sudrian Sea is a deadliest place for some, and for the Elizabeth Dane, she was lost on one April night due to greed and betrayal. So I warn you, the next time you go out on Spivey Point on the Sudrian Sea, watch out for the Elizabeth Dane.